stop.
Today we will be doing an experiment related to a Zener diode. The aim is to draw characteristic curve of Zener diode and determine reverse breakdown voltage. Apparatus needed: a Zener diode, variable battery, resistance, milliammeter and a voltmeter. Theory: Zener diode is normally used in reverse bias. Reverse bias current is negligible until a specific value of voltage called the breakdown or the reference. And here there is a reverse breakdown.
The positive of the battery is connected to the positive of the voltmeter. So the positive of the battery is connected to the positive of the voltmeter. The negative of the battery is connected to the negative of the voltmeter. So the negative of the battery is connected to the negative of the voltmeter. The negative of the milliammeter is connected to the negative of the battery. So negative of the milliammeter is connected to the negative of the battery. The positive of the milliammeter is connected to the P side of the Zener diode. So this is the positive of the milliammeter is connected to the P side of the Zener diode, and the positive of the battery is connected to the N side of the Zener diode. So the positive of the battery is connected to the N side of the Zener diode. So you can see the connection here. Positive of the voltmeter is connected to the positive of the battery. Negative of the voltmeter is connected to the negative of the battery. Positive of the milliammeter is connected to the P side of the Zener diode. And again, positive of the battery is connected to the N side of the Zener diode. Negative of the milliammeter is connected to the negative of the battery.
Zener diode is slightly different from PN diode. The depletion layer in the Zener diode will be very thin, and the depletion layer depends upon the amount of doping. So Zener diode is highly doped PN junction, and in reverse breakdown region, even after taking in a large amount of current, it does not burn out. In Zener diode, the reverse current is due to the influence of electric field. And in PN junction diode, the reverse current is due to the free electrons because of covalent bond. So Zener diode is a regulator voltage. So that's a voltage regulator and provides a constant voltage, whatever be the input voltage. And here the Zener diode is connected in series with a resistor. That is, series resistor limits the current and prevents the Zener diode from burning out. The N, that is the negative of the Zener diode, is connected with the positive of the battery, and the negative of the battery is connected with the P side of the Zener diode. Voltmeter is connected in parallel and milliammeter is connected in series.
here we can take the readings along the lower graduated scale, that is around 0 to 10 for the voltmeter, and the least count is 0.2 volts. For the ammeter, again the graduated scales are from 0 to 10 and the least count for this ammeter is 0.2 milliampere. For 0 in the voltmeter, the ammeter reading is 0 milliampere. For 0.2, it is 0. 0.4, it is 0. 0.6, it is 0. 0.8, it is 0. 1, it is 0. 1.2, it is 0. 1.4, it is 0. 1.6, it is 0. 1.8 is 0. So 2 is again 0. So now in the each graduated scale, in small steps, you have to take the voltmeter reading and check the corresponding ammeter reading in milliampere. So now for 3, it is 0. For 4, it is again 0. For 5, it is 0. For 5.2, it is 0. For 5.4, it is 0. For 5.6, it is 0. For 5.8, it is 0. For 6, it is 0. For 6, it is 0. For 6.2, it is 0. For 6.4, it is 0. For 6.6, it is 0. For 6.8, it is 0. For 7, it is 1. For 7.2, it is 1.8. For 7.4, it is 2.6. For 7.6, it is 3.4. For 7.8, it is 4.2. For 8, it is 5.2. For 8.2, it is 6.2. For 8.4, it is 6.8. For 8.6, it is 7.6. For 9, it is 9.4. For 9.2, it is 10. For 9.4, the milliampere goes out of range. We have to write down the observations for the voltmeter reading and ammeter reading in milliampere. For 0, it was 0. For 1, it is 0. For 2, it is 0. For 3 volt, again 0. For 4 volt, 0. For 5 volt, it is again 0 milliampere. For 6 volt, it is 0 milliampere. For 6.2, it is 0 milliampere. For 6.4 volt, it is 0 milliampere. For 6.6 volt, it is 0 milliampere. For 6.8, it is 0 milliampere. For 7 volt, it is 1 milliampere. For 7.2, it is a
1.8 milliampere. So here you can see that there is a steep increase in the current for increase in 0.2 volt of the voltmeter. For 7.4 it is 2.6, for 7.6 it is 3.4, for 7.8 it is 4.2 milliampere, for 8 it is 5.2 milliampere, for 8.2 it is 6.2 milliampere, for 8.4 volt it is 6.8 milliampere, for 8.6 volt it is 7.6 milliampere, for 8.8 volt it is 8.4 milliampere, for 9 volt it is 9.4 milliampere, for 9.2 volt it is 10 milliampere, and for the 9.4 the milliammeter reading goes out of range. So after taking down the observations, we have to plot the voltage versus the current, reverse voltage in the x axis and the output current in milliamperes in the y axis, and it is plotted in the third quadrant. So here the scale taken was one unit is 1 milliampere, and on the x axis, and on the y axis one unit is 1 volt, and the breakdown zener voltage is 7.2 volt. Result: the reverse breakdown voltage is 7.2 volt. Precautions: connections should be clean and tight. Voltage should be increased in steps.